It's just after noon on the Friday, and the Classic Boat Festival is underway. We're looking in here at the docks, and it would appear that the Classic boats, the majority of them, have arrived. And I'm sure there will be others coming in, late stragglers coming in. The gates are open, so let's have some fun. It's Saturday morning, day two of the Victoria Classic Boat Festival. The Ship's Point has been transformed overnight, and the kiosks are all set up and ready to serve the public. The classic boats themselves have all arrived, and the gates are open. The Inner Harbor is shared by many entities, and here we see the Victoria Harbor Airport. It's the new Victoria Harbor Floating Airport that was just installed this past spring. Adjacent to the Classic Boat Festival, we find another festival underway this weekend. It's the Vancouver Island Blues Bash, a very popular festival. It's early in the morning, and the folks are just lining up to get an early chair, an early look around in the Blues Bash Festival. So we'll join them a little later on in the video here to listen to some of the tunes. The gate is open to the Victoria Classic Boat Festival, and already the crowds are forming. It's time to have a stroll along the docks and have a look at the fantastic display of classic boats. HMCS Oriole is once again the salute vessel for the Classic Boat Festival this year. She's acted as the salute vessel for a number of years now. She's a classic boat in her own right, and a very fine vessel at that. The HMCS Oriole is a training vessel for the Canadian Navy. And as such, she's well known in these parts and a welcome addition to the Classic Boat Festival.
So he said,
That's Flying Cloud.
Thank you.
Yeah, memories are long.
Yes.
Because it wasn't climbing the sea, was it not?
You know, Bobby, it's more like, you know, ocean, right?
Yeah.
It's funny to think they're classic.
Yeah.
From Poland. Welcome to Canada.
Yeah.
And you're living here now.
Welcome to Canada.
Thank you.
Yeah.
They have a kayak.
It's like...
More good mechanics around here than you can shake your head. I don't know where when I was going to get parked, but now I just want to get
this boat. Oh yes.
And another boat, so but that was many years ago.
Right, that's right.
Yes, we do. Well, this is just here. We're on about 30 cities.
Anyhow, we're at the concert. Yeah, they're out of the cottage. Oh, we're going out of the cottage, and I got my camera and put it on the road.
Thank you.
It's Sunday morning, day 3, and it's sail past day. From our vantage point in front of the lighthouse at the Laurel Pond Inn, we'll be able to have a good view of the vessels as they slip through the narrows here on their way out to the outer harbor or past the breakwater at Ogden Point. The vessels will come fairly close to the land, and we can have a good look at them underway.
Motor vessel Coho, the ferry between Port Angeles in the USA and Victoria in British Columbia, Canada. It's the first trip of the day for the Coho, and a lot revolves on its arrival and departure. As far as the Victoria Classic Boat Festival's sail pass. Once the Coho docks, it unloads its passengers and takes on passengers going the other way. And then the HMCS Oriole, the salute vessel for the Classic Boat Festival, will depart prior to the Coho departing. And once the Coho is left, then the string of
classic boats will leave the harbor. The motor vessel Coho is a classic boat in its own right, built prior to 1950. It has been sailing these waters for over 50 years now, as the main link to the USA from Vancouver Island. There's a brave soul out for a bit of a roll. HMCS Oriole is underway here as it sails out to take up a position outside the harbor at Ogden Point. The HMCS Oriole is a classic boat built in Boston, Massachusetts. The HMCS Oriole was privately commissioned and for many years was the Commodore's vessel at the Royal Canadian Yacht Club on Lake Ontario in Toronto. She was commandeered during the war as a training vessel, and ultimately purchased by the Canadian Navy and moved to Halifax, where it continued on as a training vessel. In 1954, it was relocated to the West Coast, where it's an officer's training vessel. Quite a nice vessel, for sure. She's well known up and down the coast and around the world. She's sailed in many offshore races, from off to Maui, and which she won in a couple of times. And she sails up and down the west coast of North America. It's time for the ballet on water, performed by the Harbor Ferries and the Harbor Taxis. They go into the Inner Harbor itself and do a little show for the tourists. The folks aboard the Coho have a good opportunity to see from above if they're sitting in a higher position. This is a tradition with the Harbor Ferries and taxis. Taxis are relatively new in the last couple of years.
The ferries have been here for many years. Well-used and well-known facility of the waterways here.
Thank you.